I have my ass, I can show it off, I can get those millions of followers, but I don't want that.
Actually, like doing this is very uncomfortable. Yeah. All these women has to be like this in the photo, like that hurts.
Right now, the pressure to be sexy on social media.
And they treat you like a queen and they're so nice. They embrace your curves and like, wow, she's so confident over here. Oh my gosh, she shouldn't be wearing that. Porque se ve bien gorda.
And when it comes to female empowerment, is our Latin culture harder on women?
They destroyed me.
The ratings, the negative things, that's what's
it cheese me.
We're sounding off on some of the hottest topics in Latin music and culture. You know we always keep it real, mi gente. This is Cultura Clash. Dímelo, dímelo, dímelo. Welcome to Cultura Clash. With us today, we have three amazing, extraordinary, hardworking Latinas. The one and only Chiquis.
Oh, thank you.
And of course, we have the one and only Ana de la Riera.
Muchas gracias.
How did I do with the introduction? Lisa?
Amazing.
And we cannot forget, last but not least, Latin Grammy winner, Carla Marcin.
Thank you.
We're going to keep this conversation honest, open, and transparent. O sea, hot. And let's begin. Does our Latin culture play a role in holding women back?
Ooh.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about it. Let's talk
Absolutely.
About it.
Absolutely.
Oh, honest, God. Open, and transparent, please.
You got time?
I got time. Is your time?
You got, no, of
I'm
course.
Like,
yeah, go Carla.
Girl, do it.
No, I think it happens all the time. I mean, Latinos are the worst on machismo. Man, the worst. The worst for everything, man.
And also in bed, too. They're super machistas in bed.
In bed, yeah.
Yeah. Right? No, yeah. Sam, I'm just saying.
I'm saying talk about it. I'm taking notes over here. Talk about it.
Oh, my God. I'm having so much fun.
I just feel like hombres in Latin America are taught to be these strong guys, and they've held all their emotions for all these years. And so they feel like that gives them power. When I released my album, Déjenme Llorar, and I was doing really, really good, and man, I was being compared left and right. I was being bullied como loca. And I remember a couple of years ago, I was on tour in Philadelphia. I was playing a show. Everybody was like, oh my God, her curves, this and that. And at the same time, there was this Levi's campaign coming out in Mexico. They destroyed me.
Wow.
In Mexico. And here it was like, everybody was like, girl, you're thick. And like, I was like, oh yeah, I was feeling myself.
Yeah, of course.
And then I go on Twitter and I'm like, and like, esta gorda, esto de, like everybody. And it was just so much. And I was like, wow, I feel like I'm in two realities. Mm-hmm. Because here I don't feel that bullied. Mm-hmm. And in Mexico, they're destroying me. What's going on?
And the worst part is like, they accept that. Like they can say that on a comment on Twitter, like or national TV. And it's fine. And like, there's these young kids watching and they think that it's fine to tell that, oh, she's fat or she's old. Like, it happened to me the same. Like, I was promoting my show and there was this journalist who just said that that I looked old, that I look horrible, that my career was over. And I was like, he would have been fired if it wasn't
in the English.
You can't say that about someone else's look. You can say that you don't like my show or that you don't like the writing or whatever, but you cannot say that about someone's physicality or someone's looks.
Yeah.
Like, and that tends
and
to
And they
be,
get away with that. There's this guy called Ivan Mallorquin who did two cartoons of myself in Mexico back then. Mm. And he did like a big time, like it was a cartoon of me super fat, like trying to get to a hamburger.
Wow.
Or like me being inspired by Ronald McDonald, mm-hmm. because that was my boyfriend. And this guy got away with it.
Yeah,
and so, and this is all siempre Latinos.
But why do they get away with it though?
Because we allow it.
Yeah, because we've allowed it. And I mean, honestly, Latin television, I'm sorry, but a lot of these shows are the worst.
Oh, yeah.
You know, they eat you alive. It's the ratings, the negative things, that's what sells in.
Me.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That's what sells in our, and it's kind of, and it sucks. It sucks so bad because then you go and do something in the Anglo world and they treat you like a queen and they're so nice. And they're like, yeah, like you
embracing
just like,
your culture.
Embracing your, yeah, they embrace your curves and like, wow, she's so confident over here. Oh my gosh, she shouldn't be wearing that. Porque se ve bien gorda y esto que lo otro. And I'm just like, es nuestra. Yo veo que en la cultura latina, instead of us pushing each other, it's like you see someone rising. It's like, what can I do to bring that person down? And then you see others and they all help each other. They uplift
community.
Each other. And that's why community, they're so successful. And that's, I think, the main thing. It's like, hey, instead of aplaudir subiendo. Wow, she's doing good. She came out of the dirt and now she's rising. It's like, ooh, no, ya se cree mucho, bájala. You know what I mean? But the problem is the
young kids, because they all watch this show with their mothers and their parents or their fathers, and they're looking like, oh, that's okay to say to a woman. Uh-huh. It's okay to say that that woman, oh, she looks this way, she's old, she's fat, she's whatever. So that's what it scares me, because it's hard to change someone like a 60-year-old man.
Exactly.
But like the kid, like, come on, like we
need to change that from the root.
I think it's a lot of unpacking within our culture, right? That's the machista.
In the media, they want to make you
against each other,
and they don't do that with men. They always do it with women.
Y le aplauden todos los hombres.
Yeah.
We can do the same exact thing. Y le aplauden lo que ellos hacen. I'm just like, wait a second. I'm human. I have a heart. Why can't I date someone? It's like, here's this, you know what I mean? It's always a conversation. It's like, they are hard on us. So it's like, that. This is where we, as women, have to come together, support each other.
And you know why us women tend to be very hard on women? Because that's machismo. That's the root of it.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
That's machismo. So I feel like sometimes when women are picking other women, like, no, no estás bonita, baja de peso, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. It's really that machismo that is in us that is coming out. It's a root. So I try to practice being like, I've always been very como open. When I see a girl that's hot, I'm like, girl, you're hot.
Women empowerment is exactly that, uplifting each other. Instead of talking negatively and criticando and judging and all this stuff.
Female empowerment is something that we needed, because us women have been put down for so many years. I see a woman and she's part of my team now. I feel like now I'm with my sisters. I don't feel like, oh, somos competencia.
Social media is important, it's essential. But why is it that, like, the more provocative the post is, the more sexy it is, the more likes, the more comments?
I've noticed that lately.
Morbo.
You know?
Yeah, it is, it's morbo. You can post something super positive, something with a beautiful quote, and you're not showing any skin, and you're absolutely right. You don't get as many likes as you would if you're showing whatever, you know what I mean? Less clothes. I have un cuidado de piel, and I came out with a cellulite cream, anti-cellulite cream, which obviously we know.
I need
It's
something that I've struggled with my whole life. It's hereditary, you know what I mean? So it's like, it's algo que dije, you know what? I need it, I'm gonna use it. So I posted a picture of, you know, my butt, but no one saw what I wrote, the important part. They just saw that. I don't have the most perfect butt or the perfect legs, and I get that all the time. Oh my God, estás muy gorda, this and this and that. I don't care. But to me, I posted it to empower other women like myself without having to say the word empowerment, just saying, look, boom, here it is. I have cellulite, I suffer from it. I have it all over the place. And boom, I love myself. And you should love yourself too. Okay, artists are supposed to be perfect, untouchable. They're, you know, they're smooth and they're face-tuned and everything's just perfect. And I'm like, I'm not. Before anything, I'm a woman. I'm a human being that suffers just the way the people that are following me do. And it became this thing, and someone commented on it, like a man, and it became something really crazy. And I'm just like, wow, I'm used to it. I'm kind of marinated in this already, where I'm just like, but I was like a dude commenting about a woman and saying certain things. I ignored it, you know, to be honest. I have no time for that, but like, I did it more to show, hey, I'm not perfect. You know, I mean, I think people know that, but you know.
Who has decided to determine that what is a perfect butt, what is a good butt? And what are your thoughts on sexy posts? Are you okay with that? Do you feel it's something that is pushing female empowerment?
I think it's all on you, as a person. I don't tend to do posts like that, because at the end of the day, with comments or no comments, that's me exposing myself. But when I see girls doing it, I don't mind it. I think that's super awesome. And if I were single and bilingual and ready to mingle, I would do it.
Dropping bars over here.
Exactly.
Put that on a rap.
Exactly.
I would do it también, pero I don't think I need that. I think what I need is just, I think the confusion with social media is that we want more power. We want more attention, but for what? Mm-hmm. You should give yourself power and attention to yourself. That's what's gonna make you happy. No comments, no followers are gonna fill the void that you're trying to avoid.
The numbers that people,
So if you're posting sexy pics and people are reacting to that, qué bueno. Yeah. But that's not gonna fill the void that you have inside.
The other day, right, I was at my cousin's house. She's 11 years old. She's on TikTok, right? And she's doing these dances, and some of them are a little like provocative. And I'm like, Dios mío. I'm like, tell her, what do you know?
What are your thoughts on like the younger generation seeing women posting or perhaps sexual dances or provocative posts? Do you feel that that's causing a harm? Do you feel that's okay for the younger generations?
You know, I've thought about it a lot because I don't have kids yet. I raise my siblings. I think about it, I'm like, would I want my children to see that? And I'm like, you know what? At the end of the day, I can't keep my children from seeing everything or hearing certain things because you're going to hear it at school. You're going to see it on social media. Now it's just all you got to do is type something in Google and everything comes up. So it's our responsibility as parents to speak to our children about these things, to speak to them about, you know, the LGBT community, to, you know, because they're going to run into maybe, you know, the same sex couple kissing, and we have to explain these things to them. And if you see a girl showing her butt or showing her body or whatever the case may be, then you have to, I think, have those open conversations with your children.
I just go to, you know, on Instagram and I just like every single picture. Like, I'm like, let's just make everyone feel good, you know?
That's
like,
a couple of heart emojis here. What would you tell?
Yeah, también es como dejar vivir.
Exactly, like what? Like you're following people, you follow them because you like them, uh-huh. Right? And then why wouldn't you put to have like, because it's like they're your friends or people that you like, and it's like, yeah. Whatever, like to everyone.
Yeah, like, for me, I'm like, live and let live, whatever makes you happy. But you know what I have noticed is if you're a thicker woman and you're showing some, it becomes more, it's more provocative, más vulgar. Mm. But when you're a thinner, fit J-Lo, she can do whatever she wants and she looks great. I love it. I'm always like, I'm all about it.
Do you feel that there's pressure right now to be more sexy in society?
I think there is pressure if that's what you want to get from your social media. If you want a 12 millones de followers, yeah, shit. Like, I have my ass, I can show it off. I can get those millions of followers, but I don't want that. I do music, I connect with people through music and poetry, yeah. And things like that. There is pressure according to your principles and values. Mm-hmm. If you want that, if that's what motivates you, then okay, you're probably gonna feel pressured. If you know that life, when life is beautiful, is the simple things that make life beautiful, it's the relationships you have with your girlfriends, with your family, then you don't mind, you know?
Also, I think sometimes it's about age, I guess. Like, I remember when I was in my 20s, like, I was all about, like, crop tops, and I wanted to be like, you know, going out and finding a guy and going to the club, whatever. So I think that's also fun, you know, like if you have that age, like right now, like I don't care. Like I'm like, you know, like I'm just too lazy about it. It's just too much work, you know. But if I do look good in a picture, I'm like, yes, fuck, I'm gonna post it. Like, I look amazing.
Yeah, I think if you do it for to get attention, and that's what fulfills you, then there, I think there's a problem. But if you do it because you feel good about yourself, and it's kind of like, it is, that's what I think is most important. What really, why you're doing it. If you're doing it for likes, that's a problem. You're focused on the wrong thing.
But it's also, it's dangerous because the younger generations that are not taught at home what is important, they think that's important. Yeah.
What are your thoughts on men who objectify women in their music writing female empowerment songs?
I just feel like there has to be like all type of music, you know? Like sometimes women also, you know, are being sexy and saying, you know, there has to be sexy songs, there has to be sad songs, there has to be empowering songs.
I agree with Anna, for sure, because I do feel like you kind of choose what you're gonna consume.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. It's like, sometimes I feel sexy and kinky, and I want to hear those songs.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I want to party and I want to get sexy, you know?
Yeah.
But then there's other
just
days when...
Just
yeah. Exactly. Yeah, like... I saw you. Exactly, but then sometimes I'm like, I want to listen to Coldplay and be all like,
depends.
It depends. So I think it's more like, they're objectifying, but sometimes you want to feel like, you know, you're in the mood. So I do feel like it's a hard question because obviously there's people that don't agree with that, and it's okay, también. It's fine.
Mm-hmm. Music is a form of expression, and I think that everyone's kind of allowed to express whatever it is they want. That's their art. And if I don't like it, I won't listen to it. You know what I mean? And I just, I see that men in their music videos, there's girls in tangas and dancing and all that stuff. And I'm all for it. If that's, she was okay with it being
exactly.
in your video.
Exactly.
More power to her, more power to you. But when we want to express ourselves a certain way, like, you know, Cardi B did and Meg Thee Stallion, I'm all about it. She wants to talk about her private part and this and this and that. Girl, that's great. I listen to it. I love it. But then here come the men. Oh no, that's, just be quiet, because for years, it's been said men express themselves about women, and here we are, we gotta take it. You know what I mean?
But you know what is interesting for me is that you see these videos, right? That there are those videos are the fantasy of men, right? And these men, those are their fantasies. But the thing that we have to be careful about is that we're kind of copying those fantasies. That because they've been, you know, they've been for years, and that's what's actually in trend, you know, like having those. And then now women are doing that, and it's like, that's actually not our fantasies. Maybe sometimes, like sometimes, like you want to feel like, yes, go, right? But sometimes you want to feel, you know, but sometimes, yeah, go, guy. No, but sometimes you want to feel more like more sensitive. Like I think, I think some, like we should do videos, should we do videos about how we imagine, like feeling sexy. Mm-hmm. Like I think sometimes we are copying the men's fantasy because we've been consuming that for like. Well, 20, 30 years, like those reggaeton videos or those sexy videos. And now we should think about, no, actually, I don't like to, like, as actually like doing this is very uncomfortable, you know? Like, it really hurts my back. Like, all these women have to be like this in the photo. Like, that hurts.
Yeah.
Like, I like to be like this. I feel sexier like this.
Yes.
with my tummy like this, instead of like, this, right? So that's the men's fantasy. So that's what we should double think
about
in
the music videos.
In the music
videos,
it's like
the reality. La realidad es cosa.
So what is the female fantasy?
Mine is this one.
I'm right there with her.
This is great. After every good conversation, it's time for us to reflect, right?
I love this that we are three women and of course a man. Talking about things that are real, that we're living, there has to be more of this. We have to, you know, use our voice for these types of things. And again, we're not always gonna agree or be on the same page, but that's what it's about. It's about listening to each other and respecting everyone's opinion, you know, and their feelings about whatever subject it may be.
And I think also beyond everything, we're not only men and women, but we're humans.
Exactly. Like
humans, you know, having this experience, this life experience, we do have a spirit inside of our bodies, and we all have something going on, so we have to be respectful.
I'm just very happy to be here to meet you all. And also, you know, because you were talking about like the collaboration, I'm just waiting for our trio. Like we're gonna do a song, the three of us together. Because I wanna become a singer. So now I wanna be like, you know, on the Billboard charts.
Sitting like this in the video.
We should do this video.
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for this collaboration.
Yes. I love it.
Number one song next year.
What an amazing conversation. I was about to say, Thank you.
Okay, you'll be the guy. Yes, we're going to be perreándote a ti.
I'll wear the booty shorts. Sí. I'll wear the booty shorts and I'll start perreando.
Yes. Cool?
Live to learn, you learn to live. Ladies, thank you so much for being here. What an amazing show. I felt the energy. You look great. Keep killing it. Keep representing our culture. And ladies and gentlemen, quédense pegadito como el arroz en la cazuela. This is Cultura Clash. And next week, we have another amazing episode. Love and light.
Estrogen.